All right, we're going to kick this off in 1 minute. Everyone hang tight.
Virtual Entertainment Programming Network, tvepn.com.
Yes, everyone, welcome to another edition of the Slam Show. We have such a great program in store. I am the main head DJ, mixer, remixer, producer of this whole ship, Slam and Sam, at your service. And before I start, I'd like to have my co-hosting staff introduce themselves.
I'm Lady Sage.
Bad Karma.
DJ Stallion.
And we have a special guest co-host in the house. He is also catering tonight. It is
Lil
J's. bring it up a little bit on the mic.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, a little J's. Bit.
My name's Aaron Locke, but Lil J's.
Lil J's?
Yes.
All right. And also in the house, we have our special guests. And we'll go ahead and have them introduce themselves. Don't fight for the mic time.
I'll go first. This is Chad Briscoe in the house.
All right.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Chili B in the house.
All right, gentlemen. Thank you very much. It's such an honor to have both of you guys here, as well as Aaron from Lil J's, because we do have a lot of good stuff to talk about, especially what's happening with your guys' careers and the things that are going on with it, and especially you, Mr. B, because you took some time off of your massive traveling to come into the studio.
Yes, thank you. And I want to thank you for having me back here again.
Most welcome. And Chad, being able to book this a few months in advance, and boy, out of the ordinary, you're here with Chili B, Bay Area legend, Pittsburgh's finest.
Well, thank you. It's an honor, and I've been looking forward to this since the first time you asked me. So it's a pleasure to be here with this young man, and
he's very young.
Actually, everyone here, but you know, it's nice. It's an honor, and you know, just looking forward to it.
Yes, and being able to get into the show, it's going to be exciting. There's a lot to talk about, but before we do, we always talk about our past week's recaps, and I just want to go ahead and jump straight to my cousin. If you don't know who he is, his name is Noah Coughlin, and he is actually doing a run across America. I'll be putting up a quick little picture of his Facebook page. And basically, he's going from California all the way to Boston, 5 months on foot with a little, like, wagon trailer thing.
It's like a baby stroller. Like, you know, when mommies are, like, you know, jogging and they have that three-wheeler thingy? Mm-hmm. That's what he's running.
Yeah, he got it with one of his baby mamas. He borrowed it.
And that's your cousin?
Yes.
Really, I saw that on the news.
Yeah. Wow. He's actually making it happen. He did it in 2010 for Ben Disease Awareness, and he wants to give it another shot. Back in 2011, he had a support van, which is a van that follows him and kind of helps out with whatever. Mm-hmm. But this time, he's just going straight solo, which is an incredible accomplishment.
Wow. And don't forget, he is carrying a huge flag.
Yes.
And not too long ago, he already had a flat tire.
Yeah. So I think it was his first day he had a flat tire pushing that stroller.
Wow.
So I'd like to tell everyone out there, all the viewers, listeners, show your support. Go to his Facebook page, Noah Coughlin. Like it. Follow all of his efforts. He will enjoy every little mm-hmm. bit of likes that you click on. And also, if you're able to donate, definitely support him on that behalf. So, yeah. 5 months, he'll be on the road.
That's tired thinking about that.
Nice.
Running. This is the second time running?
This is the second time.
Wow.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's on tour too, huh?
Yeah, basically. So it's going to be an interesting accomplishment, and we just hope for the very best, because I was telling him, I'm like, wow, you're going to go solo?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's tough.
Going solo. And he's not going to be running at night, so he's not really endangering himself. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, you are being exposed.
Oh, yeah.
And you are by yourself. And if you don't have the proper equipment, GPS or things that will alert authorities.
A gun.
a freaking machete.
Something. Yeah. Especially those three-eyed dogs out there.
Yeah.
Down there.
He was saying all kinds of crazy stories when he did the 2011 run, where he would encounter these like mutant dogs that would just run out of like some country hillside and just go through like barbed wires and just
chasing them.
Whoa.
Yeah. And luckily for him, he had the support van where he's just running up there and he's diving in like Superman to save his life. I don't know how he's gonna fight this one off.
Wow. What are these, wild dogs or domestic?
They were domestic dogs that are trained to attack. Oh, if you're anywhere like trespassing within a certain vicinity. So yeah, it's going to be interesting how he combats that, because he is going to go across, I believe, Texas, and that's where it happened.
Mm-hmm.
He's going to just become a faster runner when he goes.
He's going to probably ditch his stroller. He's like, I'm fucking out of here.
Exactly. Or flatten more tires. So once again, good luck, Noah.
Good luck, Noah.
Oh yeah, definitely.
We will follow his progress, and as always, be sure to hit us up whenever you get a chance. Give us a call, Skype us, whatever, and we'll see you in 5 months. That's for sure.
Wow,
all right. Also, this past week, Friday over at Hamachi Lounge in Walnut Creek. We'll be doing that in 2 weeks again. Saturday was Panetta's in Pittsburgh. That was popping. And Sunday, we had our cosplay shoot.
Yes,
Sage?
It's for the comic book series Shadowhunters. Jason Duby, who is the creator of the comic book of Scattered Comics, this is actually the third time I'm cosplaying, but the first time for Slam. So we did that, and just stay tuned. I mean, hopefully we win first place. This is for a submission to actually be on the front of a comic book.
Yeah, nice. Exactly.
Or back, or middle, whatever.
Yeah,
nice. Yeah. And if you're not really familiar with what the term cosplay is, it's basically copying the exact character that's on a illustration publication and just getting it dead on, you know, to the shoes, to everything. Mm. And I think I hit the jackpot on this.
Nice. You didn't put like any behind the scenes stuff.
No, we
up
can't
there?
Reveal that.
Oh, wow.
Because when it hits the actual comic, knock on wood, then that will be the full reveal.
Nice.
Yeah, we don't want to kind of
ruin the surprise.
Exactly. Yeah. Thank you.
Well,
good
luck, guys.
But the trailer's up on YouTube, isn't it?
Yeah. The little quick 15-second one.
Yes, we had like a little movie sort of feel trailer, so check it out. It's under his YouTube channel.
Mm-hmm.
Nice.
That's right. And that's basically what Sage and I did. Does anyone want to chime in on their weekend?
I just did that Hamachi with you on Friday, and it's chilled, doing some video work for Saturday and Sunday, just in the studio.
Cool. Aaron, how was yours?
My weekend was busy.
Busy?
Yeah.
That's it?
Busy fornicating or busy?
work, we did a car show, Antioch Fairgrounds, and then after that, a little nightlife.
There you go.
Okay, nightlife is good. And gentlemen?
Me? My weekend was busy doing chores.
The honey-do list?
That's pretty much it. Did chores 8 hours a day. We had to do it this weekend.
Hey, when you're not traveling, you're doing the domestic stuff.
You got to make up for a lot of stuff, a lot of trimming, a lot of picking up, and a bunch of stuff that has to be done.
Sounds pretty adult to me, but yeah.
I got some trim this weekend.
It's all good. Chad?
Yeah, I just worked. I do a lot of hours up there at the steel mill, so had to put it in and spend some time with the kids. And you know,
nice.
For me, that's average.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Working kids. Yep.
That's cool. All right. This week coming up, we have Saturday Lift Lounge in Walnut Creek. I'll be video mixing there and be able to show that Blurred Lines video that everyone keeps talking about. The naked ladies walking around. Mm-hmm. That's like the top video. You heard that, right? The Robin Thicke?
I
forgot.
Yeah.
Chili B doesn't listen to current stuff. It's like, it's all mine.
Nah,
all my stuff that I listen to.
I know Robin Thicke's name has been coming up a lot in the past week.
Yeah.
I don't know why I've heard that. Blurred Lines. Don't know what it is.
Yeah, exactly.
To be honest with you.
Yeah.
Kind of out of loop on it. But
it's okay.
I just know he's been trending a lot, so...
Yeah, he's making moves.
So he's making videos, and there's naked women in the video. And
yeah, it's done tastefully, though. Yeah, it's not like some raunchy booty shaking stuff or twerking.
He's actually also
seen the video.
He's also in that show, The Real Husbands of Hollywood. Do you guys watch that?
Sorry, I don't.
He's watching Home Turf.
I'm stuck on Home Turf and Rap City.
Home Turf with Dominique.
Well, check it out. It's on, I believe, Oxygen. Channel, so yeah,
that's
pretty
cool.
Good.
Right on.
I don't know what channel that is.
We need to bring that back, Home Turf.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Karma, you are back from your disease inflicted outing. How are you back to normal? No,
I'm still diseased. So by the way, you guys want to hit a doctor up by the time you get out of here?
You wear a condom, Karma.
Oh, we have to get
tested. Oh man, I'll burn down the bathroom right about now.
Damn.
Yeah, unfortunately, Karma was unable to make it last week due to some tetanus issues. So,
rotten vagina.
But he's back. He's back wearing the...
You just have a lot of diseases we can't count.
Oh, yeah.
Welcome back.
He has like three types of AIDS.
You guys are roasting him. I love it. All right. We're going to go ahead and take a quick commercial break and be back with our first interview with Chad Briscoe, talk about his SkyPay Hoops organization as well as his music endeavors.
Hmm.
That's for sure. All right. Everyone hang tight here on The Slam Show.
Here we go. This is Sky.
Flyers. Graphic design.
Graphic design.
Marketing and advertising. Visit us at www.bayman.com or give us a call at 650-571-5100. Baymanda offers 5,000 UV-coated club flyers starting at just $99.99. Place your orders today for rock-bottom prices at baymanda.com.
And now you know who's best.
If your child is not breathing, roll them onto their back. Check airway is not blocked. Gently tilt head back, hold nose and breathe twice into mouth. Place heel of hand in center of chest and push down 15 times. Repeat breathing and chest massage until help arrives. If your child is...
You know how to help your child if they've stopped breathing. But do you know how to help them if they have a drug problem? Visit drugfree.org for information, help, and advice. This message brought to you by the partnership at drugfree.org.
Quality never goes out of style. And the quality of the Paul Frederick White Pinpoint Oxford dress shirt at just $19.95 will make it the staple of your wardrobe. This special introductory offer won't last forever, so act now to get the quality, comfort, and style you can only get from the Paul Frederick White Pinpoint Oxford dress shirt. Order today and receive free monogramming, a $9.75 value. Go to 1995shirt.com and enter promo code COLLAR. That's 1995shirt.com, promo code COLLAR.
This season, take tailgating to the next level with Mr. and Mrs. T Mixers. Hand off some Bloody Mary mix in original, bold, and spicy, and premium blend varieties. Delivering true made-from-scratch taste with game day convenience. Mr. and Mrs. T Mixers promise perfect cocktails, even if the season isn't.
Goodyear presents awkward conversations between guys in cars.
So you admit you have tire amnesia?
Yes, I have tire amnesia.
Aha.
I do not remember what brand of tire I happen to have on my own car.
Yeah, it's like you don't care.
Dude, I
now,
do...
Now, see, thing is, experts, people who really put their tires to the test, like NASCAR, they don't have tire amnesia.
But I'm not an expert.
Because NASCAR prefers Goodyear tires.
I'm not an expert.
Oh, and the first tires on the moon, Goodyears, chosen by NASA, heard of NASA?
Yes, will it make you happy if we pull over and see what kind of tires I have?
Eh, you don't have to. These Chevy Volts all come with Goodyear Fuel Max tires. They can help you save gas.
Wow, I have Goodyears?
Oh, so now you care.
Yes, I care. I care.
Goodyear, more driven. Receive up to $160 off with mail-in rebate when you buy four select Goodyear tires with your Goodyear credit card. Goodyear credit card purchases subject to credit approval. Certain conditions and restrictions apply. See retailer for complete details. Goodyear official tire of NASCAR. NASCAR is a registered trademark of the National Association for Stock Car Auto Racing Incorporated.
I Twittered all that stuff about that guy in the moment, you know? I never thought it'd be right there when you Googled him. I mean, it makes him look like, you know? Oh, I actually became a customer of his before he closed. Oh, man, the internet. You got to stay on top of that thing.
On the internet, everyone is entitled to their opinion. Even this guy. That's why there's Reputation.com. Reputation.com understands that negative material about you online, no matter how untrue, could impact your reputation and your business. And you may never know the extent of the damage. Reputation.com helps you control how you look when people search you, managing reviews of your business, and pushing down misleading and malicious search results. Act now and get a free reputation assessment conducted by our expert advisors. Call us now at 800-283-1144. That's 800-283-1144. Or go to reputation.com.
My name is Rania. As a little girl, I was told stories about witches, monsters, and the power of their evil. But then things changed. As I matured, I learned to harness and embrace that same energy for good. I guess I became what I was told to fear. I became a witch. And while I learned that not all monsters are to be feared, I know that there is a darkness, an evil waiting to devour us. I will use my everything to destroy it. And I'm not alone. I'm joined by Jenna, a vampirous gangbanger, and Jessica, a green-maned werewolf. We are the monsters breathing fear into the nightmare of every demon. We are the Shadow Hunters.
Follow the horror action comic book series Shadow Hunters at scatteredcomics.com. Like us on Facebook for updates of the Shadow Hunters live action movie.
Are you sick and tired of flies ruining your afternoon festivities? Well, look no further. Bug Assault's patented fly-killing technology is a safe, simple, and effective way to vanquish these pesky creatures. Not only are flies notoriously dirty, they're fast. Its 3-foot range of use gives you the element of surprise over even the most adroit pests. With this innovative salt-powered device, you can keep pests at bay and enjoy your day. It's really simple. Fill it with ordinary table salt, then just pump, click, and hit. Because Bug Assault fires tiny granules of salt, there is absolutely no mess, making cleanup a cinch. Forget those inorganic sprays and rid your yard of unsightly traps. Bug Assault is a non-toxic and amusing alternative to traditional methods of insect eradication. It is perfect for barbecues, restaurants, warehouses, and households. We are so confident in the quality of our product that we offer a 30-day money-back guarantee. Take your freedom back. Order today.
Yes, welcome back to the Slam Show. We're going to just go ahead and jump right into our guest interview. Usually this is where we talk about sports and news, entertainment, all that shebang. But we got so much power here in the studio, we just don't have enough time, so we're going to just get right down into it. I'll throw up a little video of our guest that's coming up first. He actually runs a program. Yes, I did it right for you. How do you like that one?
Nice.
This gentleman, he actually is from South Central Los Angeles. He moved over here to Pittsburgh when he was, what, roughly 16?
16 years old.
16 years old. He became this freaking Michael Jordan of Pittsburgh High basketball for a little bit. Since then, he's been doing a lot of things within the community. He's a director of Sky Pay Hoops. He's also a coach. He deals with a lot of charities. And he also has an aspiring brand for music. as he's going to add that into his repertoire. Let's have a big round of applause for Chad Briscoe.
Yeah.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. Appreciate that.
You're here.
Yeah, finally made it.
You finally made
it. Finally made it.
You made moves, and I said, I got to get Chad on because he's doing too many things, and I'm seeing the stuff that you're doing with the whole basketball program. Let's just back up, man. I thought you were going to be in the NBA, honestly, because of you were such a kick-ass in high school.
Yeah, well, I guess if I would have made it, I probably wouldn't be here right now. So
You're wrong.
I look at things like that.
You're wrong.
Oh, you would have had me. You would have
Well, because
me.
We've had former NFL players that have nice careers, and they come back in. So, man, don't brighten it up more than it should be. You will be back here regardless of what direction you take in life.
Yeah.
But, yeah. Watching you back in the day was incredible. You were just like Michael Jordan with freaking jetpacks.
Well, it was fun because, you know, everything that I've done up until that point, it was all just heart, what I wanted to do.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't have anybody to push me. I didn't have anybody to say, hey, let's go out and play. It was all me. And, you know, I just wanted to come out here and give back because a lot of these kids don't have that. You know, like
outlet.
I didn't have it, but some kids need that push, and especially what's been going on in the last 7 to 10 years out here in Pittsburgh, nothing's been done with these kids, no programs available, and you know, it's just a shame to see from what we come from back in the late 80s, early 90s, to what it is right now.
It has deteriorated.
Yeah.
A lot.
Yeah.
As far as what your program SkyPay does. I've looked into it. It's wonderful, brother, being able to make this happen and have that as an integral part of what we need to have in Pittsburgh, because it is lacking from how it was back in the day where there was a lot of programs and a lot of things these kids could do.
Mm-hmm.
Having that type of organization has really put in such a great word into the city, and being able to have kids say, hey, we can go ahead and still hang out in our neighborhood and be able to do something productive with our time.
And that's what I wanted to kind of create.
Right.
Give these kids hope. I mean, it's just, it can just be the littlest thing to get these kids going. It doesn't have to be something, you know,
major.
Great and, you know, magical. It's just the little things to show that you care. And, you know, running programs for kids and, you know, being able to through the school district has really opened up a lot for me and giving these kids an opportunity, like running the camp that I did last week, Dribbling for Diabetes. You know, being up at the school every Saturday running a program called Saturday with Coach Chad with all the middle school kids, it gives them something to do, for one, on Saturdays, and it gives them hope because now I'm going to be bringing back the junior high basketball program in Pittsburgh. So now I'm training these kids, giving them something to take with them. Some of these kids are in the eighth grade, so they're going to be going to high school. Some of these kids are in the sixth and seventh grade, so now they have something to take to their league when they play next year. So it's a win-win situation for everyone, and I love it, you know, and it gives me an opportunity to do something that I love that's really easy for me to do.
Right.
But at the same sense, it's showing these kids every Saturday when I adjust my schedule at work to be there to show them that, hey, this guy's here and he's showing up on his own time.
Yeah,
so,
that's great. Mm-hmm. And can you explain to our viewers and everyone, how did you come up with the name SkyPay?
Oh, SkyPay, a lot of people ask me that. I have two beautiful daughters. One is Skylar and the other one is Peyton. And they're actually really my motivation. So every day, you know, they've been with me. They've done signups with me. They've been to every camp, clinic. One of my daughters, Peyton, she does absolutely nothing with sports, but she's there. She's in a corner playing with her dolls and she's having her own little fun and doing her own little thing. But Skylar, she's into everything. So it's good to have them there and good for them to see me do things with other kids so they can get a sense of, you know, wow, my dad is really taking the lead and trying to help these kids. So I enjoy them being there. So Skylar and Peyton, that's where I got the name from.
Well, you better give them a shout out real quick.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Skylar, Peyton, I love you, baby.
So having that ideal that you want to go ahead and have this transformation with the community in terms of having these this organization become more like something where everyone could rely on to reach out and say, hey, I want to have my kid be part of this. Is it something that you want to just keep it within just basketball or in other sports as well? What's your What's your focus on that?
Well, initially I wanted to open it up. Well, first I started with just Skypay Hoops.
Mm-hmm.
But then after I started seeing like all these other sports that weren't, you know, the kids weren't really benefiting from, or there was nothing there for them. And then I turned it around into Skypay Sports. And then I wanted to do softball and I wanted to do track at the junior high level as well as basketball. But then now with the new AD, Mike Adrian from Pittsburgh High School,
mm-hmm.
he's doing that now. He's taking the lead on that, so I can step back a little bit and just do the basketball part of it. And this allowed me to do a little bit more because now I'm getting in touch with other organizations like Kaiser, American Diabetes Association, and they're you know, looking at doing things out here in the community as well. And they're looking at partnering up. They want to do some work with me and allow me to come into this community and really do a lot activities with the kids and implementing sports and awareness, and that's key. So when you can have an awareness, when you can speak to the kids, and then you can actually go out there and do something, that's, you know, two different components, and
right.
you put those together, now you have a good program.
That's
and
that's good.
What I wanted to do. That's exactly what I wanted to do.
You know what I'm also hearing nowadays is that there's a lot of like college scouts out there mm-hmm. that are seeking the talent within the junior high school mm-hmm. levels and
yeah.
kind of saying, hey, in about 8 years, I'd like you to come to my
yeah.
school.
Yeah.
At this level right now, are you seeing any kids with that type of potential? Like, that might be the next LeBron James or Carmelo Anthony. And when you see that, does that person get extra attention, or are you just going to say, hey, I'll teach them on the equal level across the board?
Well, I haven't really seen that in Pittsburgh.
Right.
I've seen it.
Oh, snaps.
Yeah, I've seen it a couple other places, but at the same time, you see these kids, they don't even have the drive behind that. They have the athleticism. They're real
right.
good, but that's it.
Mm-hmm.
They don't have anybody to push them.
Okay.
And I've worked with a few of those, and it's like, wow, if this kid really gets it in gear, he can be something. But for some reason, where he comes from or the people that he's around,
right.
he's not really motivated. And that's what I don't like to see.
Yeah.
So I would rather take a kid who has potential and push them for greatness because they want to do it.
Mm-hmm.
They want to work and they want to strive. So I see it across the board, but I have ran into a few. But special treatment, the only thing I would do is just train them different, because you can't train someone that's just starting with someone who has, you know, a lot of skills, because I can't teach him the basic dribbling drills
yeah.
that I have to teach this newcomer over here. So
yeah.
it's definitely different.
That's a good definition of what I'm trying to get at, because it's funny because you're seeing so many guys that could do the dribbling
yeah.
behind their backs and between their legs
mm-hmm.
and they'll be talking to you and holding a conversation.
Yeah.
And you yeah. ask me to do it, I'm like, well, oops. It's such a talent to do
yeah.
that. So much props on mm-hmm. the whole Skypay Hoops thing.
Mm-hmm.
Let's go right into the whole Briscoe management, because I know this is something that spans into music and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And to my co-host, have your questions ready, because after he answers this, it's going to go down the list with what you want to break down with Mr. Briscoe here. Talk about it.
Briscoe management, I was actually working with a young lady who, I mean, I can pretty much spot talent across the board. If you're pretty good at something, I can kind of spot it.
Mm-hmm.
And she was a pretty good singer. And I started working with her, and
it's not Rosie Gaines, is it?
No.
Rosie Gaines used to work for Prince, and is from Pittsburgh.
Yeah.
Yeah. Rosie Gaines is not a pretty good singer. Rosie Gaines.
She's a
great singer.
Singer, but no, not her. This was another young, inspiring singer, but things just didn't work out.
Okay.
So I came across another young lady, and who had a little bit more to offer, and I started working with her. And then I came across a phenomenal PR and started working with her. So we kind of teamed up together, and I brought the Briscoe management, and she brought the PR. Shout out to Miss Tanisha Gladney, Rising Star PR. And so we went in, started getting some talent, and she knew a couple of artists that that was looking for some management, and kind of got with them and kind of sat down and wanted to put a plan together, because you don't want to just go in and say, okay, yeah, I can just manage you, let's go.
Right.
We wanted to kind of sit down and do something different with Briscoe management, and we wanted to kind of make sure that we had a platform and kind of a layout for these artists, so when we get new artists, we know exactly what to do with them. So it was a learning process, but now we're in a phase right now where we have a couple of artists that's having releases right now.
Oh, cool.
artist by the name of K Ross. He had his CD release party last month, which was awesome. Over 500-600 people came and showed up, showed support. Have another young cat named Young Deuce, who's out of Reno, and he's putting it down. He has a few songs, and he's in rotation right now. We're doing a radio campaign with him. He's in 7 or 8 different major cities right now, and he has a nice song with Ray J and YG.
Oh,
and shout out to him. And also, we have a young man named Prince Sear. His album is coming out at the end of this month, and he hails from Niagara Falls, New York. So he's everybody.
Yeah, nice roster
there.
Yeah,
everybody that we have is actually you know, on their way.
Okay.
So it's just a process and a matter of time right now. So I'm telling them to kind of be patient,
right,
and
right.
still plug away and let me do this part and you do the creative part.
So, nice, nice. Yeah. Well, congratulations on that endeavor, man.
Thank you, thank you.
That's, you're just blowing up. Not on the hoops
busy
end.
Just trying to stay busy.
Yeah.
Busy man.
Exactly. We got a miniature Jay-Z in the house.
Without the money.
We didn't say miniature, so.
So let's go ahead and go down the list, starting with Chili B all the way down. Go ahead and have a question for Mr. Briscoe.
Mine is not so much a question, more than just an acknowledgement, really, for what you're doing. And working with the kids and stuff, I have a heart for the kids as mm-hmm. well. So, I mean, we have a lot in common from a lot of areas, from me being an ex-hooper myself, yeah. you know. But I think that I just want to just commend you, man, on everything you're doing, and just to say that I wanted to come out one day and be able to help you out on a Saturday
definitely.
With your kids, you know, just to volunteer my time and do what I can to help you out here.
Well, definitely. I know we just kind of talked a little bit. I mean, just to even have you out there, these kids don't know you.
Yep.
But, you know, it would be nice to have you out there just so they can get a sense of, wow, you know, this is somebody who has yeah. been there, has been doing it and still doing it.
Yeah.
And, you know, all these kids need is hope. And all they need to see is one person to kind of really step up and say, you can do it. I'm just like you. I went to the same school as you did.
Absolutely.
And I'm from the same area you are
yeah.
from.
For
so
sure, man.
That's what it's about.
Well done, man.
Yep. Appreciate it, man.
Lots of love in the studio.
Yes. Well, my question is with your organization. I know kids out there are into sports, but they may be lacking in the education process. They're mm-hmm. not so good in, you know, math skills or any, you know, mm-hmm. skills out there. Just wanted to do sport. Now, is your organization going to guide them through like having tutors available, not just so focused on sports but also in education?
Well, definitely, that's one of the things that I wanted to get into, but first I had to kind of step in with what I know and then slowly start adding people, because what you guys don't understand is Skype Hoops is not a nonprofit. I do everything out of my pocket. I come out, all about my time is volunteered, and I do all this by myself. So I'm looking for people to come in and help. And I'm looking for good people, not just anybody. So once I start really get going, I want to implement the educational part as well.
Great, thank you.
So let me ask you this. As far as Skype Hoops, now you mentioned Kaiser and some other people that jumped on board with you. What has the city done anything with you at all as far as to help you out, maybe giving you locations that you can run camps, money to help you out, or even, you know, leads as far as kids, you know, this is an area we need help in, or have they done anything with you?
Well, actually, no. Working with the school district, that's really where I get my help. Like I said, Mr. Adris, his name is Mike Adris. He's the new director of athletics here at Pittsburgh through the Unified School District. He's allowing me to do everything because he sees what I'm doing, and he knows that, you know, I'm really here to help the kids. It's been, 8 months since I've met him, and I've been running a program for 7 months. So he saw what I had to offer, and he let me run and do exactly what I wanted to do, but within the guidelines of making sure that I'm doing everything that I'm supposed to. That way, you know, everybody wins. So I'm not really getting support from the city. I haven't really reached out yet because I wanted to go to those that I know who would help and then start slowly branching out. I didn't want to start going from, you know, different angles. I wanted to start small so people can see exactly what I'm doing, embrace it, and then lend a helping hand.
So are you going to actually, you know, ask for some, maybe, like I said, maybe a field for a certain time or a court for a certain time amount of time just for, you know, Skype Hoops?
Well, eventually, yeah, but right now I'm at Pittsburgh High School and I have the main gym. I don't know if you've been up there yet, but that
yeah,
gym is huge.
I heard it's nice.
That gym is huge and it has 3 full basketball courts. So, yeah. They're allowing me to do what I need to do up there. And, you know, for now, I was actually talking to a friend of mine. Shout out to Chef Mimi. Shout out to Chef Mimi. She's a very inspirational young lady. So we were talking the other day, and I'm actually looking to put on a health youth fair and using the parking lot and the gym at the same time to keep kind of people contained in that one little area.
Yeah.
And have some kind of like triathlon thing going on. That was a great idea that she had.
Triathlon.
Yeah. And just get the kids and the parents involved. So it's more of an awareness and, you know, using your athleticism and getting out there and competing and having fun. So that's you know, really what I want to do.
Nice. Aaron?
Not really a question or anything, but just want to say, you know, give you thumbs up for what you're doing. I was unaware that Pittsburgh didn't even have a basketball league or any activities like that or anything. So it's a good thing that you're bringing it back. And one thing Pittsburgh does have is a lot of pride. And I think a lot of the kids don't really even know it, but it's there. Growing up and going through school and everything, it's a very powerful thing. So you definitely have my support, and I'm pretty sure once when you start getting it all together and it starts coming along, you'll get the city's approval too on it. So you definitely have my support.
Well, thanks. It's really going to be huge to get this program back, because you think about it, when you have something in place for kids to take with them to the next level, that's huge. You know, it's just giving them that sense of, like we were talking a little bit ago about having that pride in, you know, the school that you represent and your little area that you represent. Having these other leagues is okay, but when you get into your school pride and representing, that's huge. And I never had that opportunity because I never played junior high basketball. I've come to Pittsburgh as a sophomore getting ready to be a junior. That was my only 2 years playing, and I was so excited. So I can just imagine kids in junior high playing basketball and representing their school is going to be huge. And they get to take something with them to the next level. So now you can't compete against De La Salle and all these other schools because you don't have anything to compete with. These kids have been playing over that hill for 6-7 years strong, and they've been in camps and clinics. So that's what I'm trying to bring on this side of the hill, so we can keep the kids here instead of these kids traveling to go to these schools in Brentwood and Oakley. Keep them here in Pittsburgh. So you have to offer these kids something, give them something, and keep them here.
Yeah. Go Pirates.
All the way.
Pitt. Cool. So who's the basketball player that inspired you to start wanting to play sports and basketball, and what musician wanted you to go, hey, man, I want to get into producing and music?
Basketball, I would have to say my older brother. It's crazy because I was telling Slam, when I was 13 years old, born and raised in South Central LA, being affected by the Crips and Bloods, I told my mom that I didn't want to be here anymore. I just felt that it was something more for me to do. So she put me on a plane and I flew to Texas by myself at the age of 13, and my brother was in college. And playing ball with him, he actually led the nation in scoring. And I was just happy to be around him and his friends, but I was actually playing with him and his friends and didn't realize that what I was doing and what he was doing was actually grooming me for what I was doing or gonna be doing later. So when I got to Pittsburgh 2 years later, they're like, wow, how can you do that? And I'm like, do what? You know, but I'm playing with grown men at the age of 13. So now I'm here in Pittsburgh and I'm so far advanced that I'm just loving basketball and just using it, not, you know, bragging or being boastful. It was just easy for me. So I really enjoyed that. So I would have to say my brother on that one. And music, I've always loved music. Just listening to a lot of music. But because I had a young lady who needed help, and that's just me, she asked me for help with the music thing. So I said, okay, I feel that I can do anything that I put myself, my heart and my mind to. You can't tell me nothing unless, I mean, I'm not going to really advance at a lot of different things, but I will try. So that's one of the things I like to stress to my kids, at least try, because you never know. So I tried it. I met some good people, and now there's no telling. So yeah. I'm just excited about the whole process of working with the kids, working in the music, and just exploring and trying to see what else is out there for me.
Cool. You ever think about putting sports on the end of your name instead of basketball? Because you can expand out to maybe like, you know, baseball or something else too that other communities might need.
Yeah, definitely.
Here goes your stallion suggestion. He always adds on to every guest. He'll get one for chili too.
I'm always looking to do different things. You can add anything on the name on the back of that. I'm just really trying to be someone positive and just try to tell people that you don't have to have a lot of money to run programs. All you need is a heart and your time. You know, I work sometimes, you know, 60, 70 hours a week. I still have my own kids. I still have to go out here and run these programs for other kids. And I'm not getting any funding. So I love what I do. And people always ask me, how do you, you know, where do you get the energy from? And it's like, from these kids, because they're here. If they weren't here, then I wouldn't have anything to do. But because they show up, I have to be there. And it's fun for me because I feed off them. I get energy from them. So everything that I do, I just try to use it from the heart. You know what I'm saying? Because it can, you don't have to have a lot to give. And that's what I'm trying to get these kids to understand, that all you have to do is just say hi to somebody. You can make their day. It's just the little things that, you know, that matter to people in general. But for kids, it's a little different. So I'm just trying to tap into that so they can see. And then now they can use that when they go out and be with other people.
Fantastic. Chad, we're going to wrap this interview up in a little bit. 3 to 5 years from now, where do you see Briscoe Management or SkyPay at?
I see myself actually kind of in the back and having other people run it, because I want to get other people involved.
Oh, so you want to pull Donald Trump and just kick back and let him come in. All right.
Well, I want to get a lot of the young kids involved so they can get a sense of giving, you know. And it's like a domino effect. You know, they see what I'm doing, and they want to jump aboard.
Yeah.
And then other people see what they're doing. But I want everybody to be on the same page.
Mm-hmm.
So now I can sit back, and I can run everything that I need to run. I can be more effective that way. I can't do it all by myself.
I can't picture you doing that. I'm picture you being on the ground, getting dirty with everything.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Well, yeah, 5 years, maybe not, but I got to do it now, right? And everything else that I'm tied up in right now. Like, once again, I got to give a shout out to Chef Mimi.
Chef.com. Okay, Chef Mimi. Okay.
Yeah, because she's very, very inspirational.
Like, Chef as in cooking. It's not like a first
name.
She's
a professional chef.
Okay, just want to make sure.
And, you know, we have a lot of plans in the future. So I'm looking to really expand those things.
Cooking show?
And I'm looking to expand those things.
Open up your own network now.
You know, and, you know, like I said, she's very inspirational. And, you know, there's a lot of other people out there like that that's supporting me. So I'm just looking at trying to get Briscoe Management, SkyPay Sports up and running. I want these kids in the community to benefit from my knowledge and my expertise in this sport. And if I can do that and bring good people along with me, then that's what I'm looking to do.
That's fantastic. I know you don't have too much time on your hands, but do you follow any sports like in-depth, NBA or anything?
You know, actually, NBA, I haven't really...
kind of soured because you're not in it and stuff like that.
Yeah, you know, I didn't make it. So, you know, it's like, yeah, forget those guys. But sports is not the same for me like it used to be. So now I'm trying to create my own for these kids.
Gotcha.
Because they don't even get out anymore. They like to sit around and play the video games.
Mm-hmm.
And it's taking the fun out of these kids being active. So that's why I come up with all these little different camps and these little clinics and these little Saturdays, and just to get them out the house. You know, just to show them that you can still do what you need to do, but you still need to do that activity and be around other people, you know, just to feel like, you know, this is something that, you know, I hold dear to my heart.
Yeah.
And you just come out and just have fun, because these kids, they don't do that anymore. And it's just a shame. So, yeah.
That's fantastic. Well, Chad, I am so glad that you were able to come on the show, share your story, share your efforts on what you're trying to do for the community. Mm-hmm. And gosh, I wish you the very best. Everyone here on the Slam Show, we want to see you succeed and make this work. What's the website and Facebook, Instagram, Twitter that people could...
Let's go skypayhoops.com.
okay,
that's my website. I need to update it, but it has a lot of things that I have going on up there. I do personal one-on-one basketball training. I do league trainings. I do camps, clinics. I do pretty much across the board. And also, I didn't mention, I have an invention. It's a basketball training tool that's actually was presented to a corporation 3 weeks ago, and I'm just waiting to hear executives they want to pick it up or not.
Okay.
And if not,
it's not the watch thing that you're showing earlier.
No, that's another invention. So I have three inventions, but I have one that's in the works right now, and the other two are just waiting.
So
I could invest $5.
Okay, I'll take it. I don't know what you can get with it, but I'll take
a battery.
Not even a battery, golly.
And Facebook is Chad Briscoe. That's Chad E. Briscoe.
Chad E. Like Chad E.
E. Like Chill E. Chad E. I think that's where I got it from. Inspired. Chad E. Briscoe. And Briscoe Management page on Facebook. So you can hit me up on those. And like I said, skypayhoops.com. Check me out. I have my package up there. Get your kids active, involved, and get them ready for the basketball season.
Perfect.
A quick question for Chad. What's the youngest child that you would accept to train? Like if I had like a 6-year-old niece, is that too young?
That's exactly where I like to start, 6 years old.
Perfect.
And that's perfect for my invention because it starts for it's for kids who is just getting into basketball and just learning how to dribble and kind of get the fundamentals down. It's a good tool. So that's why I wanted to start at.
Nice. Perfect, perfect. All right, let's have a big round of applause for Chad Briscoe.
Chad Briscoe.
And I want you to hang out because after the mix time, mix break by DJ Scoop, we're going to go ahead and roll into our exclusive interview with Mr. Chili B.
Okay.
And you get to ask him some questions. His turn on the hot seat.
All right. And I have an answer for every question.
Yeah, I'm sure you will. All right, everyone, we're going to go into the mix time, and it's DJ Scoop. Everyone, hang tight. We'll be back in 20. Hang loose here on the Slam Show.
You're now rocking with DJ Scoop.
Versace, Medusa head on me like I'm Numinati. This is a gated community, please get the fuck up the property. Rap must be changing cause I'm at the top and there's no one on top of me. Niggas be wanting a verse, but man, that's not a swap to me. Grinding in compliments, pool in the backyard that look like Metropolis. I think I'm selling a million for sweet man, I guess I'm an optimist. Born in Toronto, but sometimes I feel like Atlanta adopted us. What the fuck is you talking about? Saw this shit coming like I had binoculars, boy. Versace, Versace, we stay at the mansion when we in Miami. The pillows Versace, the sheets of Versace, I just want a Grammy. I've been so quiet, I got the world like, what the fuck is he planning? Just make sure that you got a backup plan, cause it's like I'm in handy. Started a label, the album is coming September, just wait on it. This year I'm eating your food and my table got so many plates on it. Hunted this TV at my house, I sit back like, damn, I look great on it. I do not fuck with your new, man, don't ask for my take on it. Speaking of lingo, man, this for my that trap out the bendo. This for my that call up Fernando to move a piano. For your no feeling, cause business is business, it's strictly financial. I'm always the first one to get it, man, that's how you lead by example. Versace, 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 Versace. Word in New York is the indictment, and high schools are calling me Poppy. I'm all on the low, take a famous girl out with it, no paparazzi. I'm trying to give Halle Berry a baby and no one can stop me. Versace, 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 whoa, Versace, 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 Versace.
worried about none.
None.
I ain't 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 worried about none.
None.
Round round with that whoop. Strapped up with that Nina. Got two bad bitches with me. Knock will feel. Money don't mean nothing. Don't feel you when they see it. My whole hood love me. But now they wanna touch me. I ain't worried about none.
Friend is a dirtbag, and everybody knows your boyfriend is a dirtbag. Your mama tells you so. Your boyfriend is a hat. You got to let him go. Your boyfriend's a dirtbag. Even his mama thinks so. There ain't no way around it, you really gotta know. That cover up is sweet but phony, got that candy coat. You try to make the truth look like it's something good, and you perform like he's a star reppin' Hollywood. I know he said he's sorry, but I see nothing real. And yet his mouth keep running, track and field. So maybe you can help me understand why you do that. Tell me why your boyfriend's a dirtbag. Girl, everybody knows your boyfriend's such a dirtbag. Your mama told you so. You know what she said. You gotta let it go.
Whoa!
way she slow dance, she make me throw more bands. Grabbing her with both hands, she in love with the dope man. She wanna be my main chick, I was thinking different, different. Clap that out, light up blown, baby, let's get ignorant. She strip for the G, rate cash like Lee. She got double D's and ain't she free. Came with my goon, but I'm leaving with a deal. With an Flex Arena and a face like a Leo. Red bone and some red bottle. She finished college, she a head doctor. Bouncing there, well, I'm getting out. As propellers on a helicopter. Let's do it again. Me, you, and your friend. We don't even need a room. Give me a stop in my Benz.
In my Benz.
Where my double cup. Time to blow it up. Got a bounce. So bad you can't afford the fool. Bounce.
Bounce it.
Bounce it.
Bounce it.
Bounce it.
You know what? Yeah. Cause bands will make her, you know what? Yeah. And I can make a girl break fast. My pants be on that too much lunch. Ooh. And I'm about whatever, baby. Take a photo, I'm looking good. And these breezes is so beneath you. Understand you're misunderstood. Premium level goods. We pay whatever for it. Over these. Only under influence. The buck up, then a back out like that. Roll a pack out, take a light hit, might nap. Got a thick boot with a trip stick. I'm smacking a bucket. Probably nothing but that. Ball head, scallywag.
Salute me.
That Memphis game.
Say by Rudy.
I'm Mark Gasol, a Shelby though. That's plenty though. That's Juice J. For Lauren got it, then get me though.
Bounce,
bounce it.
Bounce,
bounce it.
Bounce. I'm about to throw a couple thousand.
Bounce,
bounce it.
Bounce,
bounce it.
Bounce.
I'm about to throw a couple thousand.
Trippy and paid up like Diddy. Toss up the cash and she showed me her kitty. Got some white girl and a white girl. Doing my 10 a lot off of her. Ain't tryna just find a replacement. Feeling so global, I think I need Asian. Ratchet on deck and they know I'm gon' stunt. I'm tryna get hit while smoking a blow. Take it to my hotel, beat the boot up. I don't know her name, but I wanna boot. Along came on, then came Duke, then Cole in a styrofoam cup. See me in the club, bands pop, they poppin'. Do it real good, might take you shopping. All these racks can't fit in my pocket. Keep that sack, 100K in the stocking. Then it's back to my room, she come out of dress. Slob on my nose, think you know the rest. I don't buy these Ross Nikes, but I keep these girls in check. Working for that money, you gon' have to break a sweat.
Bounce,
bounce it.
Bounce,
bounce it.
Bounce it.
Snapchat, baby girl, give me Snapchat. 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 Snapchat, baby.
Send a pic to my phone. See, we snap it up and we chat it up, but them 10 seconds ain't long. I'ma need more sex, more minutes. Strike a pose with your clothes missing. Take another one, pose different. You in the mirror, you gon' get it. Snap it up, make a little video, back it up. I ain't really tripping, I ain't acting up. If you got a big dunk, I'ma shack it up. My swagger on extreme, yeah, we in this. Shout out to the team when you hit a click.
Click, 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 click. Snapchat, baby girl, give me Snapchat. 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 Snapchat, baby girl.
Snap,
this little picture right. And she's showing everything I like. Baby, you look good from head to toe. But why your kid up in a picture though? Work, work for some high use and a purse. The only thing that makes it worse is sending pictures from a church. And I just hopped up on this flight, but I wanna see you drop it first. And when I get to where I'm going, send a few without your shirt. Click, 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 click. Snapchat, baby girl, give me Snapchat. 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 Snapchat, baby girl.
To my motherfucking man, 50 grand, an alcoholic man, and jack a tall can in his bloodstream if he can. Biggie Smalls, the 50 stroker, MC provoker, chocolate tie smoker. Hey? I like to max and maximas and Acuras. Your girl butt cheeks, I'm smacking. Huh? The raw rapper, spine snapper, with the little cause on my lap. You know the flavor, Macca. A shot, the butt, I ain't your fucking comforter. And if I ever fall in love, I bet I'm f***ing up. Ask the f***er if I didn't chuck her. If she try to front, then I drop the Chucky Booker on.
Why you wanna play games on me?
You're crazy, commitments, I'm swayzy. No time for the ill shish. Rest with the niggas on that real blood spill shit. My rapping tactics are drastic. Stretch your motherfuckers like Mr. Fantastic. So if you wanna see my pedigree, you better be filled with energy. It's never getting me.
March 9th.
Don't push me. Revenge is like the sweetest joy next to getting pussy. Picture paragraphs unloaded. Wise words being quoted. Beat the weakness in the rap game and sold it. Bow down, pray to God, hoping that he's listening. Seeing niggas coming for me. My diamonds when they glisten. Now pay attention, rest me please, father. I'm a ghost. In the killing fields, Hail Mary, catch me. If I go, let's go deep inside the solitary mind of a madman. Screams in the dark, evil lurks, enemies see me flee. Activate my hate. Let it break, till I'm flaming. Set trip, empty out my clip. Never stop to aim. Some say the game is all corrupted. Fucked in this shit. Stuck, niggas is lucky if we bust out this shit. And plus, mama told me never stop until I bust a nut. Fuck the world if they can't adjust. It's just this way. Hail Mary, come with me. Hail Mary, nigga, run quick, see what we have here now. On the ride or die,
Vanilla Tracy, Caesar Bugatti, Isaac Mizrahi. Fuck around the Doce, Gabbana sipping pure Z with the ill nana. Nigga, you fuck around. I had your loyalties and your joint. Nigga, your royalties and your points. So what the deal is? With Foxy Brown McKay. Now we lace Bonnie McFly. Now I'm up in Jamaica breaking all your paper.
You're the only one for me. You're the only one I need. Can nobody make me the way you're making me feel. And girl, you know this love is real.
Break it down, break it down.
Oh, don't let me, don't let me.
He's just gonna cha-cha. Nothing, yeah, nothing special. He's just gonna cha-cha.
Do the move.
Do some bachata or whatever.
What?
Sam gotta move.
I'm not freaking the Batman.
One move.
What's that guy from Japan that we saw? The dancer from Japan. Can't think of this guy's name, but he was sick.
was on America's Got Talent.
Yeah. What's his name?
I don't know.
Hey, wasn't that dude sick? He did that Matrix stuff. He
yeah,
did,
yeah. Oh,
man,
yeah,
he did something that I thought was impossible.
Yeah.
I was playing
and
the
I
table.
Thought you don't watch TV.
No, I saw the video on
YouTube.
Oh, okay. I do watch TV. I do watch TV.
All good.
Arrow and what's the other little werewolf movie that we've been watching?
Werewolf.
Twilight.
Yeah.
Chili B's a Twilight fan.
What team are you? Team?
I don't even know the difference between the teams.
Come on. Team what?
I don't know the difference.
He's going to say Edward.
Trust me, I don't even know the difference or the characters.
You guys are too much.
I just look at it when it's on TV.
You're like the wolf or the vampire.
Try to figure out what the hell's going on.
Or the chick.
Oh, gosh.
You better say the chick.
You guys are too much. Well, welcome back, everyone. That was The Mix Time, brought to you by DJ Scoop from Houston. If you want to download the mix, go to his website, djscoop.com. All right, we're going to go into our exclusive interview with our special guest. He's been hanging tight the entire program, and I'll throw up a little video, a little sample of your... What song was this?
That's Y'all Bust It.
Y'all Bust It.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was the one that I believe premiered when you were on last, correct?
Yes.
And we went ahead and talked about that project as well as some of the background stuff. If you don't know who the heck Chill EB is, you are living under a rock. This gentleman has been part of the music hip-hop scene here in the Bay Area, I would say about 100 decades. And he has made his mark still to this day, traveling the world, doing performances, non-stop gentleman. He is a philanthropist. He gives back to the community. He is all the above. Let's have a big round of applause for Chill EB, everyone.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Brother, I'm glad you're on. I am so happy.
Hey, I'm happy to be here, man.
And whenever you say, I want to be on, this song comes in my head immediately.
Why is that?
This is the hit.
This was the one. My very first professional recording, should I say.
Exactly. Reminds me of my freaking neighbor next door.
Yeah. What were you, junior high school when this came out?
Oh. Technically, no. But it's pretty close.
Like high school already?
It's funny because people know you from this track, Dog Down.
That's true.
And let's kind of back up a little bit. It's more like an up-tempo, Miami bassish sort of rhythm, played in the mix sort of thing. What came to mind putting together the concepts for this track?
It's funny. You mentioned a couple of titles and things. That's kind of funny because the truth is this was before the songs that you mentioned. And the inspiration basically comes from, I like all types of music. And I just got this drum machine and programmed this little real simple beat. And a friend of mine, Pittsburgh buddy, Mike Dorsey, we call him the head hound, mm-hmm. dad, whatever. He was the one that came with this idea. Dog Down. This beat is cool, man. And he just came up with these two words, Dog Down. And he started doing this a variant of the dog. The
right,
dance
right.
called the dog.
So, right, right.
Oh, we're going to make this into a song. And then Desmond Smith from Pittsburgh, he told me, Chill, you're East Coast style rapper. You only can rap, so I bet you can't rap fast. You should do something kind of fast. Took that as nice little
challenge,
you yeah. know? So we put this beat together the next week, and we debuted it at the Antioch Fairgrounds. And of course, all my local friends and everybody kind of went. That was like the whole thing.
Was that a performance or just played it?
I started out as a promoter in this area because I was looking for venues that I could perform my songs on.
Yeah.
So I would do a party and put out the flyers and bring in, you know, 300-500 people,
mm-hmm.
a couple of DJs or whatever, and I perform a couple songs.
Okay.
And that was pretty much what it was. It started out like that.
So this was a performance thing that you
debuted?
It was
a performance, yeah.
So
and,
did you
we eventually
out?
Did this at the Antioch Fairgrounds at the car show when we opened for Rodney and Joe Cooley and a couple of things that was going on back in the day.
Okay.
But
have a full-blown show with dancers and everything? And you're
oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. We had dancers, man.
Was Desmond out there dancing?
We had the whole nine yards, man. Yeah, we actually, dancers from Pittsburgh area, you know, a lot of them from Pittsburgh High School.
Mm-hmm.
Melissa Brown.
I was going to say.
The mayor, Miss Bills. Miss Bills was Javon. She was one of my dancers.
D. Jamal Lilton.
Jamal danced with me at one point.
Why is Chad laughing?
Let's see, I had yeah, I mean, I had a lot of different dance crews, man, just try to make it work, you know. But it was fun. Also had two other rap partners, Chad, rest in peace, OMG, from Antioch, and of course D the White Knight from Antioch, who now lives in Houston. But that was the original crew. You know, Chad and Rich were together as a duo before I came to California. So when I moved out here, I was looking for other rappers, like-minded people, just to put together a crew and start doing stuff.
Okay, so your initial effort wasn't to go solo. It was for a crew thing, right?
Yeah, we started out as a crew, and then, you know, everybody kind of went their separate ways, and I just had to keep grinding. So I just kind of stayed persistent, you know,
right,
to keep it moving. But Dog Down was the one that actually was the one that started it all. And actually, it was a B-side. Dog Down is the B-side. The A-side, which was the most important song, in my opinion, to me, was called Freedom,
mm-hmm.
A Message to the World. And it was with the whole spirit of Martin Luther King, everything that Martin Luther King was about. In fact, we sampled Martin Luther King in the record because we were trying to bring forth peace and love and unity using music. And being an interracial rap group, we thought we were qualified to do it. So Freedom was actually the first song, was the A side.
Right.
Dog Down was the B side. But of course, Dog Down was the one that kind of went viral before going viral was the thing to do.
That's right.
And yeah, so it was a fun time, man. It was some good days back then.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. I have a unopened Let's Roll record. I believe this was the second single, correct?
That was the follow-up that came out actually 1990.
Right.
Wow.
How did this song come about?
Once again, we were trying to do something to satisfy my DJ friends, my dancer friends, and I just started, you know, 1989, going out of the year, coming into the new year. Mm-hmm. I was thinking, you know, 1990, I'm back on track. I'm dissing fools who thought I was whack, who thought I lacked the knack to move a crowd. Basically was postulating that I can still do this.
Right.
We're going to get a couple of obstacles in the way, but
you're going to keep grinding through.
I'm going to run through them. I don't stop for obstacles. I only stop for old ladies and little kids. I don't stop for anything else. And so that was the idea. So Let's Roll was just kind of me trying to keep it busy on the same tip that Dog Down was on.
Gotcha. So it's kind of like your version of Too Legit to Quit, that sort of thing.
Why do you keep bringing up this stuff, man? This was, all, like I said, all this stuff before. Was before Too Legit to Quit. I keep trying to
But see, the thing is, most people don't know you, so I have to have that connection. The closest thing I could connect to.
Yeah.
And there isn't absolutely really anything.
And that's a good comparison. Prior. That's a good comparison because I have a lot of admiration for him as well. You know. But anyway, this song here was a good song for me, and it also featured Deanna Dixon, also from Pittsburgh, and she was 15 years old. So the vocal on this track is coming from a 15-year-old superstar, in my opinion.
Nice.
And yeah, so this was kind of her debut with me. And like Mr. Briscoe was like, we're always trying to do something that's involving the kids, trying to give them hope for the future, you know, and try to just give them an opportunity. Mm-hmm. And so when I met her, she was a great singer. And I, you know, I'm going to put you on a record and try to basically put her out there was my attempt. And, you know, like I said, it was fun. That was that was part one of my career. Now I'm enjoying part two.
Yes.
16 years later.
Yes.
And it's been fun, man. It's been busy. It's been fun. And it's been rewarding.
Well, let's talk about that because you are consistently, incredibly busy for an artist that's been around for so long, which is a rare thing. You just look at everyone from the late 80s to early 90s. Who's still around?
Yeah.
Who's barely doing anything? It's the well is dry. Yeah. How were you able to continue to get all these gigs and stay busy with putting out all these tracks? And I got your new track.
Oh, you did get
yes,
that one.
Yes.
Cool.
We're going to debut that in a little bit.
Nice.
But what is your recipe for staying in the game?
My recipe, I don't know if we really call it a recipe. I just have a few things that I stay, first of all, stay true to myself. Stay true. Something I try to share with other artists, they always ask me, you know, well, how did you do this? You have a manager? Well, how did you make it? And when? How did you do this? And I just say, it's real simple. It's to stay persistent and to be consistent. That's very important. Be consistent and persistent.
Sounds always, like a song.
Yeah, I'm sure there's a song somewhere. also, be prepared at all times. Just be prepared. And really, you just have to be thirsty for that knowledge. And if it's something that you really want to do, because it's different between people, you know, things that people want and things that people really want.
Mm-hmm.
And so this is just one of those things, man. You just have to be true to your craft and just, and a lot of it, you know, it's some of it is just being in the right place at the right time.
Right.
You know.
And I think you are hitting those places.
I think so. Thank you.
Because every time I'm on Facebook or other outlets, I'm seeing that you're just in Germany, other places overseas. It's just amazing. Let's talk about like today's current music. What's your take on it as far as the quality, the artists involved, how they're doing their shows? Give me your insights.
Well, honestly, I haven't been to a concert in a long time, be quite honest. And
not even Summer Jam?
No, I haven't been to Summer Jam since 1993, I think it was, when I opened Summer Jam.
Yeah, I was there.
You were there?
Yeah.
It was a great opportunity
89,
for me.
93. All those were the best years, all the way from 89 up, because they had the food fights and everything going
right.
on.
Right, they did have the food fight that year.
It was 2 days, you know?
Yeah, exactly. But, I don't really have an opinion about the artists that are doing things now. I do know that I felt that there was a void in the rap music. I felt personally.
And when you say void, are you talking about the lyrical content, the production, or just a little bit of everything?
The production, there's a lot of great production, in my opinion. I think there's a lot of good produced songs, a lot of good songs out there. Lyrical content is a thing that is for me. Lyrical mm-hmm. content and an overall message, you know. The message, what is the end message of your song? When you listen to it as a whole, what are you representing? What are you promoting? What charge are you trying to create from the people? And a lot of it seems to be cookie cutter to me. Well, it is cookie cutter. It doesn't seem that way. It is that way. Mm-hmm. Just keep it real.
Yeah.
And
I mean, you can only get away with saying stuff about booty so many times.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. You know. And so
not I mean, like it's a bad thing.
No, it's not. But I mean, when every song is consistently of that, I mean, I don't know. Like I said, I don't really have time to really even evaluate or judge another artist or what they're doing. Right. I can support something that I really like.
Yeah.
I can acknowledge someone and say, hey man, well done, good job, and it sounds really good. I don't really want to make a critical opinion about anybody or anything, because that's not the fight I'm in. And I'm so busy with what I do and what I am doing that I really haven't taken notice to what everybody else is doing, because quite honestly, I don't care what they're doing, because it doesn't prevent me and stop me from doing what I'm doing. What I'm doing is more important to me.
Hell so yeah.
I just stay focused, man. I just keep my focus. I got my game face on 24/7. Like I said, I haven't played basketball in about 3 years, but I still got that basketball intensity.
Just like, what's his name? From Miller.
Reggie?
No.
Which Miller are you talking? Miller time? Which Miller?
No. No Limit.
Miller. Oh, P. Miller.
Yeah.
P. Miller.
Yeah. Ah. He played hoops
Master
a little bit.
P. Yeah.
Master P.
Yeah.
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 I heard he was really good.
Yeah.
He's a big boy. Would have loved to play, match him up in the paint.
Oh, that's right.
That would have been
fun. Yeah, because you were dabbling about out of the studio regarding playing hoops and stuff. Is that something you're passionate as well?
Well, yeah. Actually, I consider myself an athlete first, honestly. And how I got into music started from my athleticism. And I only played 1 year high school ball. And then I played
hoops
basketball. Okay. That's my thing. I tried football. I tried baseball. I'm horrible in baseball. I stink the game up in baseball. Football, I wasn't big enough to play football.
Really?
Yeah, honestly. Where I came from, I was not big enough to play football. Man, we got legends where I come from. North Carolina, man. The boys out there eat them weights. They start lifting weights at 6:30 in the morning before school.
Mm-hmm.
I had a couple buddies
that were beasts. And eat their Cheerios and do it again.
Oh, yeah, man. I had a couple buddies that were beasts, and they kept me off the football field.
Wow.
And then so I figured, you know, basketball was easy for me. Basketball, I had more I got more pleasure out of basketball mm-hmm. because I was better at basketball than everything else. And so it paid for my college. So I mean, I went to college until I decided that I wanted to get into music. So I left college in 1985 and came out to California for the summer mm-hmm. of 1985, and I'm still here.
That's right.
Well, it's been a long summer. But yeah, basketball is definitely a sport that I love. And it's taught me a lot, and that's something that, like Chad, I said, we have a lot in common. He knows because he's a hell of a ball player as well, and we have a passion for the kids and teaching the kids to love of this great game of basketball mm-hmm. because this game can take you other places in life. It did for me, and so I do have a passion for the sport.
It's fantastic. And talking about kids, what type of community work are you involved in now, and how is that going to develop into the future?
Well, right now I'm still on my campaign on my dissemination tour. the Chili Bee Dissemination Tour. We roll out actually again next month. We're going to be back in Australia, Melbourne, and Sydney. So if you guys are listening, let's have some shrimp on the barbie.
Shrimp on the barbie.
Yes. So, but no, I'm just doing, I'm really getting a message out there about the dangers of labeling and drugging kids. And a lot of things are changing since the last time I was here.
Yeah.
And a lot of awareness has been raised a lot since I was here last. And there's a lot of new developments that are actually, it's still a hell of a fight. You know, there's kids that are still committing suicide because of this Ritalin or Adderall or whatever, Paxil or whatever it is they're giving these kids for these illnesses and disorders. But I think these kids should be more involved in what Mr. Briscoe's doing. Get them out in front of the television, get them outdoors, breathing in some air, get them running, get them sweating, engaging with other kids in a sport that's healthy for them, be it soccer, basketball, mm-hmm. karate, whatever. But I think that is that would be go a long ways to deal with these things that we call ADHD. Mm-hmm. So my goal is to stay active on that, is to educate the parents and other people about the dangers of it, with the hopes that we can come to a resolution and end the labeling and drugging of these kids, because it's killing them, and they are our future.
Well said. Wow. That is incredible that you're aiming for that direction in terms of being having the awareness for that. And once again, ladies and gentlemen, we are with recording artist Chili Bee, Bay Area legend. And I'm going to ask one more question, guys, and we're going to go into our music break, which will be the new track that you provided, Ask the Question.
Okay.
And after that, have your whatever you want to say to Mr. Chili Bee ready. Because we're going to go right into that. As far as the entire method of the song that we're going to play, Ask the Question, what did you go with the same concepts as you did previously, or was it something that inspired you to make it? What was the ideal?
That's a good question. Thanks for asking that. Actually, the song was recorded 2 weeks after the Sandy Hook massacre, I will call it, shooting at Sandy Hook.
Okay.
And it was inspired by the shooting. And the reason that we call this song Ask the Question is because immediately after shooting, if you recall, there was a knee-jerk reaction of people saying that we need more gun control. And so then this whole big thing with the Rifle Association, mm-hmm. and people are putting, you know, well, that our president is, they're trying to take our gun rights from us. And so there's a lot of different fingers being pointed in different directions, but
yes,
they're all targeting the wrong target. What has not been done successfully and effectively is to ask the question of what psychiatric drug was this shooter taking. Because people say, well, how can this guy do this, go into a school and shoot 5 and 6 year olds? How can he do this? He killed his mom. And people asking these, how can he? Why did he? But the answer is very simple. If you find out what drug is in his system, because there's a common denominator with these school shootings. When young people walk into a school with a gun and start killing other young people, there's a common denominator. And in almost every single case, 99%, if not more, is psychiatric drugs or a psychiatric influence on this person. So if they were to do a toxicology, or they've already done a toxicology, if they were to release the report, then it would help everybody understand a lot easier what motivated this kid to do this.
Yeah.
Okay, but the bottom line, it goes back to, so ask the question is because nobody has really had the gall to ask the question. I figure I'll nominate myself to ask the question.
Yeah.
You know, what the hell is going on? So that's what the premise of the song is.
Gotcha.
I think you'll enjoy it.
All right.
I hope you will.
Well, we're going to go ahead and, is this the first time everyone's going to hear it, or it's been out?
Well, this song was released, May 13th.
Okay.
And there's only one station, I have to say, a plug, San Jose State University.
That's all good.
Because they were the first station to play this song.
Okay.
And so, I mean, I definitely got to give them props. You will definitely be the first show that I've been live on to play this song.
All right.
So, still the first.
Hey.
We have a lot of firsts.
Hey. We'll be the Virgin Eye some way.
Okay.
That's for sure. All right. This is Ask the Question by Chili Bee. And we'll be right back with the co-host questions in a little bit. Enjoy his track, Ask the Question.
The fear, the pain, it all all just seems to hit you at the same time. You see the kids in there, but you don't dare to cross the yellow line. Cause what's going on inside, it's like a terrible nightmare right in front of your eyes. But let's get back to the beginning before it all began. It all started with a kid before he had a plan. Maybe fast, maybe slow, maybe feels a little low. Bet even he didn't know that he would deal those fatal blows. Did he go to see a psych? Cause they said he wasn't right. Did he get the usual treatment and get drugged outright? Was diagnosed with some new mental disease? Was that what was happening behind the scenes?
We need to ask the question, cause somebody knows. It's one simple factor here to interpose. Yeah, how did this happen? Tell me what was prescribed. What did he take to influence his mind?
We need to ask the question,
and if we're gonna find out. Cause I wanna know, and I wanna know now. So how did this happen? What was done to his mind? What was he taking to commit this crime? We need to ask the question.
What drives a kid to go and take a life? Something about this just does not seem right.
We need to ask the question.
What twists the mind enough to pull the trigger? Look at the drugs and get the bigger picture.
We need to ask the question.
How does a kid decide it's his time to cross all the lines? Why don't we start asking what was done that they're trying to hide? But it was too late, the kid came storming into the school. Got his father's loaded gun, he's not afraid to blow. These aren't the same teams that we knew in ages past. Something is changing them, and we better find out fast. So once again, I ask the ever-burning question, what the hell kind of meds leave such a deadly impression? I'm telling you that all you people should know. The more the drugs get pushed on us, the more insanity grows. Whether from the direct intake or suffering from withdrawal, the drugs could be the mistake that took the lives of all. But they're gone now, can't erase deeds done, tears on graves. With eyes dark and stone cold, he lay surrounded by tape. So the question I ask, if he was taking the meds, could this be the reason for all the tears shed?
We need to ask the question, cause somebody knows. It's one simple factor here to interpose. Yeah, how did this happen? Tell me what was prescribed. What did he take to influence his mind?
We need to ask the question. We need to ask the question. This has happened before, and I don't think this should happen to us anymore. And if we knew who it really was behind all of this, we could prove the true killer's never been the true kid. Ask the mental doctor, was it a psychotic break? He'll answer with yes, and we got to him too late. So now we ask,
spit it, spit it.
Is he taking your drugs or just your expert advice? We'll never know unless we ask the question.
If we're gonna find out, cause I wanna know, and I wanna know now. So how did happen? What was under his mind? What was he taking to commit this crime?
We need to ask the question. What drives a kid to go and take a life? Something about this just does not seem right. Ask the question. What twists the mind enough to pull the trigger? Look at the drugs and get the bigger picture. We need to ask the question.
Yes!
Yeah.
That is Ask the Question from our special guest, recording artist Chill EB. And you obviously heard about all the conspiracy noise connected to the Sandy Hook thing. What's your take on that? Do you think it's just more publicity or some factual stuff connected?
It's actually disgusting, man. I was kind of a little bit upset to think that people would think such a ridiculous statement. I mean, there's conspiracy theories, sure, and some things are conspiracies.
Right.
Everything is not a conspiracy. I don't believe. That's my personal belief.
Mm-hmm.
And in a situation like this, I read this stuff right away. I actually wrote something about it just to express myself is that what's the motivation? I mean, some of the stuff is ridiculous. And a lot of it has already been debunked. But I think it's just basically heartless for someone to write such hateful messages from the comfort of their home behind a keyboard. And
stay anonymous.
Yeah, and people lost their lives. There's kids,
yeah.
5 and 6 year old kids. And so my thing is I'm a debunker too. So I mean, I debunked a couple of those theories so quick to the people pretty much removed the post because, I mean, it's just ridiculous and it's insulting, basically.
Yeah, and very disrespectful.
It is disrespectful. And the question that these people need to ask themselves that if they believe this is all a made up thing and everybody's actors, how do you reintroduce these people back into society? There's so many people, and I've been on the set of Hollywood type movies, and
right.
you got to do a ton of takes just to get it right.
That's right.
I mean, even the professionals, there's no one take, Jake. I don't believe in some of these professionals that we love so much. But how are these actors and kids and everybody so well trained with no background in acting that they baffled everybody?
Yeah.
I'm not buying into it, and I'm insulted by a lot of it. But like I said, I just keep my focus and do what I can do.
Yeah, it's for viral purposes, to get their little creation out there and so forth.
Well, there's people, I'm convinced that there's people that sit around with not much direction.
Yeah.
And they're looking for something to happen just so that they could have something to rally behind. They want to rally behind something, but they can't find their own cause to rally behind. So they wait for a tragedy or a death or a big thing like this, and then they go out and they grandstand the whole thing with no solutions. So I stay in my fight. I have no dogs in that fight. People are entitled to do and say what they want, but you have to be accountable and responsible for what you say and do.
Well said.
So
yeah, exactly. I know what you mean. Sometimes there are legitimate conspiracies, but that is the Sandy Hook thing just pushes it way over into left field.
Yeah.
So right on. We're gonna take this moment to have our co-hosts ask a question to Mr. Chili B, and we're just going to go down the list, starting with Chad Briscoe.
Ask the question. Probably two parts. One is the sports, okay, of course. Just want to know when we can get together and do something for these kids. Music-wise, I think adding the music to a sporting event would probably change the game a little bit out here. Having something from your caliber, and mixing with, you know, maybe one or two of my artists coming out doing something for the community, I think that'll be huge. I'm just wondering when we can do that. And also with the sports, if you can come out and talk to the kids and kind of, you know, show them who you are, I think that'll be really huge, so they can see someone else that's been there and that's done it and that's continuously doing it. I think that'll be really, really big, and that's something that I would like to see happen if we can make that happen.
Cool. Well, let's do it, man. We just be in touch. You know how to get a hold of me. I know how to get a hold of you. We just make it happen.
Okay. Sounds good. Right on, man. Appreciate that. Right on.
Right. Chad wants to put this on record for the public.
I'm not going to wait till after the show. I want to do it now.
I'm like scratching my head like, you could ask that on camera.
Yeah. So I'm trying to figure it out. Yeah.
Good one, Chad.
Okay, my question is, what makes you so passionate to spread awareness of this psychiatric drugs that's out there? Is it something that hit close to home?
Well,
or personal experience with family?
It's been my personal observation, like Chad and I were speaking, is that I coach youth basketball as well. I was a program director for the recreation after school program for the city of Concord for many years. And during that time, I had an opportunity to supervise thousands of other people's kids over a period of time. And being involved with my kids, and when they were in school, sometimes I'd be in their classroom or on campus with them, and I seen this observation of kids who were being given medication for ADHD. Mm-hmm. And then I worked at the high school, and at Mount Diablo High School, the labeling that the administrators were telling me that this kid has ADHD, this person is taking medicine for ADHD, and I kept hearing this ADHD over and over and over. And I became curious to say, where the hell does it come from? Because I grew up all over the world. I lived all over the world and had hundreds, if not thousands, of friends. And I can't tell a single one that had ADHD. And I can tell a single one that ever took any medicine for ADHD. Mm-hmm. So it was my viewpoint that ADHD is a big hoax. This is what I was thinking. So then when my youngest son was 15 years old, he was struggling in school like a lot of other 15-year-olds do. And we tried everything to get his grades up, and nothing was working. So we were asked, had we ever had him tested for learning disabilities of any sort? So we took him over to the hospital, and they gave him a test, which is basically a questionnaire of a bunch of silly questions. That was the test. And we took these results back. After we answered the question, we took them back to the hospital. And within 15 or 20 minutes, that doctor was able to prescribe my son three different medications for ADHD, said that he was a classic case of ADHD, and that we should pick one of the medicines to start him on, to give them to my son. Knowing that other kids have been committing suicide because of these pills, I looked up the side effects, and the side effects are more scarier than what you're trying to handle.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the side effects, sudden death, they lead to depression. Mm-hmm. They lead to homicidal or suicidal ideologies. You know, it's just all these effects. So I refused to give them to my son. And I said at that point, I had to come out of retirement because I wanted to share with other parents what my experience was, because maybe they were being lied to as well. So I decided to make it my mission is to get other parents to question the validity of ADHD. I mean, it's such a silly disorder that the person who created ADHD himself, before he died on his dying bed, he did his final interview with a newspaper, and he pretty much acknowledged that he made the whole thing up, that ADHD is a made-up disorder coming from his mind.
Funny you say that, because growing up, you know, I never heard of it.
Yeah.
I mean, mm-hmm. everyone in this room probably never heard of it. And then now, like in the late 90s, you just start coming up with, you know, Ritalin and Paxil and all this anti-depression stuff.
Yes. Well, see, it was voted. Basically, there's a room of psychiatrists and psychologists that meet every year, and they discuss amongst each other how many people think this disorder or that disorder should be put into our new diagnostic statistic manual as a disorder that we can treat with medication and so forth. And if mm-hmm. more than enough people raise their hand, they put it in. That's how ADHD got put in the book.
Mm. Wow. So it's just a monopoly with the pharmaceutical company.
Yes, well, they're all in cahoots together.
Oh, yes.
But now, something else that's interesting to show you how silly that book is, a simple thing, a regular thing like PMS for the ladies used to be a mental disorder. And because it was such a controversial button, they took that out of the same diagnostic and statistic manual. So they pick what they choose to be a disorder, and they pick how they think is the best way to treat them, but it's pretty barbaric. And a lot of it is all just experimentation. That's what I recognize. And so I just want to tell people what I know and use my music. I mean, I could be doing club songs. I could be, I can rap about making it rain.
Yeah,
and booty shaking,
I can twerk. Yeah, but I think a very important message, I think, is the message that I'm on right now, and it's actually been saving lives of people that we've met on the road who tell me their stories and share me their stories, and it keeps me motivated is because they tell me how it's changing their life or how it's affect their life just by a simple thing that I do for fun, which is make rhymes.
That's right.
Well, thank you. That you're phenomenal, and I applaud you for everything.
Well, thank you very much.
See, and the tone of the show is serious, but when we do have the booty shaking show, we'll have you on to talk about that.
Yeah, then we have to put on Dog Down or Move Shake or something. One of these songs.
Play at the end. Sam, got to put this song at the end so they can dance to it.
Yeah, put the kids to bed and listen to it.
No, I was just saying that because this is not even a question, but it's not my turn. But how you hit that back when we were little, we didn't have that. You know, parents used to say, oh, you got something wrong with you. They hit you with a spoon, and then you're cured for the week or the day.
Well,
they didn't have timeouts or nothing. And we were acting crazy or wilding out when we were little. You know, we would yell out and do stupid things, and we get hit across the head.
Yeah.
That was it.
That's true.
But nowadays, it's like, oh, there's something wrong with this kid. Just give him some pills.
Give him some pills. Yeah.
Give him a spoon. Give him a spoon, and that'll cure the kid. I guarantee it.
But you know what's funny? How I grew up. The timeout is funny. Timeout, we didn't have timeout. Uh-huh. My house mom called the knockout.
Yeah.
You had to say. Timeout, knockout. Yeah. But my mom had that look, you know, and that's a lot of things. I don't know if, I know black parents do this very well. Italians do it, but mom had this look that was more sinister than any type of whipping that you could get, because from across the room, she'd give you that look, and you automatically knew you did something. Your heart sunk. You got quiet. You were like the little church kid for days. So that's all it took. So I tell people, mom, we didn't need no psychiatrist and ADHD medication. Mom had the ADHD medication.
You heard that wooden spoon in the drawer shuffling the spoons, and you're like, oh shit, I'm in trouble. I hear the spoons. I got smart and I started hiding all the spoons.
You got spanked with a spoon. We got spanked with a slipper.
You guys had it easy. Slippers, come on.
I'm talking a big ass.
Come on,
a big ass slippers. Wooden spoon. A big ass wooden spoon.
Like nice.
Spaghetti and shit.
Yeah, spaghetti spoon.
Spoon.
Spaghetti scooper.
I can't imagine what a spoon.
That shit was anywhere. Put splinters in you and everything. Yeah. All right, Karma, go ahead.
Did you guys like slice it out of a tree or something?
Nah, man. My mom's mom used to hit it with the pizza dough roller.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, wow.
And then she had the wooden spoons. So we didn't have the big roller. She wooden spoon.
Whatever. Lost criminal cross back then.
Yeah, that hurt.
My grandmother, you might just get hit with whatever's in her hand.
Yeah.
Sometimes it, sometimes
or it her a, hand.
Yeah. And the worst for me was the fly swatter, because my grandmother could hit a fly without even looking. She popped a fly, and then and blood be splashed everywhere. And I used to look at her like, oh my God. And then she'd look at me and go, what are you looking at? And then she'd pop me up. What are you talking about? With her? I was like, nah.
She's glad they didn't have bugs. Yeah.
And you know, we were like, when your parents gained permission to other parents to hit you for doing bad things, then, you know, that was a cure.
That's how I was raised.
Your friend's dad's beating you with a belt. You're like, damn.
And then he's taking you home, and then you get
hit
at home.
Yeah, you must have gotten beat by spoons and belt.
Oh yeah.
Well, that's how we grew up without getting in trouble. Exactly. That's why we're not in jail.
Taught the other kid. I mean, it's like he's beating you, and he's looking at his son like, "This is you're next. Yeah. You're next." Yeah.
But you know what though, man? I called my mother years ago, and I thanked her for every ass spanking she gave me, and I thank her for it, because not only would she discipline us when we should have been disciplined, us, but she always loved us even so. You know what I mean? So the spankings that I took, which I think I took quite a few, didn't hurt nothing. Mm-hmm. And I love her for it. You know, I called her one day and told her, Mom, I got to thank you for every ass spanking that you gave me.
And that's what they need to do these days. I don't care what the law says, but they did. Parents do what we our parents did back in the day. These kids would be in less trouble.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think so. Yeah. Today, though, the law has a lot of people afraid to raise their kids.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
And you know, when you get other governments and different people dictating and mandating how you raise your kid, then it takes away some of your rights as a parent. But see, I've never been afraid of that. I raised my kids the best way I know how.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, mm-hmm. And my kids know I have great kids. Actually, just became a grandfather again for the third time just 2 days ago. I had
congratulations.
Oh, congratulations. Wow.
That was so new. I almost forgot about that one. That was so new. And I also date myself a little bit here. Granddaddy three times.
I want to date
about me.
Huh? We all can date ourselves.
Yeah.
But you know, when they say it's bad these days to hit your kid, but it's not bad to give your kids some pills and they go off and kill themselves, that's worse. I mean, they need to just sit down and think about what, go old school.
Yeah.
Well said, Stallion.
Yeah, it's not going overboard. That's all it is. Yeah. You know, it's not like beating your kid with your like you said, with your fist or anything. You spank him because, you know what, I remember my dad came around or my mom came around that, you know, it didn't happen often, but when they spanked you, you knew, like you said, that look that you got quiet because you felt bad. Yeah. You felt guilty. You knew you did something wrong. You did something, you know, you didn't want to do anything wrong. You didn't want to disappoint your parents.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know, and I don't think kids have the respect for the parents anymore. That's really what it is.
And the kids will tell you, you can't hit me, I'll call the cops.
Do it.
Be like, if you call the cops, you need to leave leave with them.
Yeah.
Yeah. And it's even worse when they hit you with that spoon, and then later on that night they're serving the dinner with it.
Yeah. They make you want to start hiding.
Yeah, yeah. I ain't eating. Yeah,
exactly. Start hiding spoons. Mom,
that's
like,
what I used to do.
Where are the rest of the spoons?
I broke them all.
Yeah.
Nice. I used to run until he said, I'm going to get your dad here.
All right, Carmen, go ahead and ask your question.
All right. So, you know, you were talking actually earlier, and you're talking about like the booty shaking stuff. And so however tempted were you to cross over and say, you know what, I'm going to go mainstream, or I'm going to go what's popular to make that kind of music, you know, to make money or to be on, you know, on the radio a little bit more exposed? Has it ever really crossed your mind?
Real simple answer. Nope. Never.
Okay.
Never did it cross my mind to do that.
Okay.
I mean, you know.
Well, it actually leads me to another one, if you don't mind, is as far as your music's been going and your message. Now, you don't really hear that on the radio, the popular radio, you know, the mainstream radio stations. You don't really hear that message. I mean, Same Love is the only one I can really think of actually throws a message out there for, you know, just kind of a learning process for people and to understanding. Got really popular. But, yeah, you don't hear about, like you said, mm-hmm. I mean, yours especially with the ask question. You
yeah.
know, that's a huge one, and I can't understand why that would not be on the radio for people to listen to.
Yeah, it's definitely not mainstream music, I don't think. I think that the influence of the pharmaceutical industry and especially psychiatry on our society, it would be cool if they did, but I'm not doing my music for radio. I've done that before where I intentionally did songs that says I got to do something that is radio friendly.
Yeah.
The stuff I'm doing now just happens to be what comes out.
Well, why do you not think it's radio friendly though?
Oh, I think it is.
You're
think
throwing,
it's radio
you're throwing
friendly.
A message out there.
Oh, yeah, for
do you
sure.
think it's something outside that's influencing saying, you know, we don't want to hear that. That's not what people want to hear.
I mean, pretty or? Much. I don't know. I don't know what it is, and I really haven't thought about it. But honestly, it would be cool if, I mean, it's definitely stuff that is good enough to be on radio. Yeah. I think it should be on radio.
I definitely do.
But I'm not going to go to the radio station to beg them to play it, only because for me, I don't really care if radio never plays my song.
Yeah.
It's not going to stop me from making them. It's not going to stop me from the passion that I have. It's not going to stop my mission. and I'm taking my stuff to the people.
Yeah.
I mean, the radio can broadcast out to millions of people in one blast. I take them to the people like Johnny Appleseed. I take them 400, 500, 1,000 people at a time,
yeah,
and just keep repeating that same thing over and over, mm-hmm, and just drilling that message home. It's funny is that, you know, in the Bay Area, I don't know if the Bay Area, they're just not aware. I don't know if I haven't campaigned a lot here with the radio station to get them to play my music as I did back in the 80s and the 90s. I don't know what it is. I mean, with the internet now, I'm sure that the local radio stations could just throw through and find me songs, yeah, like they find everybody else's.
Mm-hmm.
But it's quite funny to me that I get radio stations in Australia,
yeah,
playing my songs. We have the largest radio station in Italy. I'm on rotation in their radio station. And I've been on the air in all these different places, and Hungary, of all places, on the radio and TV over there. But in the Bay Area, no radio love. I'm just like, well, what's the big deal? I don't know what the big deal is, but like I said, if they play it, cool. If they don't play it, that's cool too. The show still goes on.
Yeah.
But they're missing out, I think, that's right, and they're missing out on an opportunity to disseminate this message to people who need this message more.
Yeah.
But I think the music that is really selling happens to be the music that has the tone level is really a lot lower in terms,
exactly,
of and the respect level. And it's just the stuff that's making money, and that's what it is, a business. And that's why I'm glad I'm not really on a major label, because had I been on a major label, they may tell me to start doing booty shake songs,
yeah,
and quit, yeah, talking about these people. But yeah, as long as I keep doing my own label, yeah, I keep saying what the hell I want.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Well,
booty
you for
shake,
that.
Booty, yeah, shake, booty,
good,
shake.
Good question. Thanks for asking, man.
Thank you.
I guess my question is, like, when did it all start? Like, when you started, when you were younger, when you started writing down lyrics and coming up?
Well, let's get back to the beginning before it all began.
Okay. Oh, I have a talent for this. Like, when did you, yeah, pick up on that?
Actually, it, for me, with King Tim III by the Fatback Band. Do you know that song?
No.
Fatback Band.
I probably heard it.
Song?
Yes. Probably heard it.
There's a lot of rap artists out there, and
I still have the 45 of that.
Of King, wow, Tim III?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Did you
on
say
the 12-inch?
Did you say 30?
No. 45.
45. Okay, 7 inch. That's why we don't.
Okay, I have that. Yeah. So that tells you how long that song was. Well, anyway, I bought that record when it first came out. And well, actually, I bought Sugar Hill Gang, Rappers You Like, when,
okay,
it first,
right,
came out around the same,
okay,
time.
I know
frame,
that one.
And actually, just to give you a little trivia, the Fatback Band, King Tim III, was the first commercially recorded rap record as we know it.
Before
Rappers Delight. Now, yeah, if you ask this question, they say, what was the first rap record? People are going to say Rappers Delight.
Mm-hmm.
That's not true.
Okay.
King Tim III, you heard it from me.
Okay.
Okay, and so anyway, that was what my love began. But at the time, I was pop locking. We had a little group called the East Coast Poppers, me and my high school buddies. And so I was the guy wearing a size 13, moonwalking across the stage, light footed.
Size 13.
Size 13, sliding, you know. So that was what I was doing, this, you know. And then I went off to college and started, you know, performing in frat parties, writing my ideas of raps, rapping to other people's instrumentals. And I was rapping at different frat parties and so forth. And I said, oh, you know, I like this because this is an easy way for me to communicate something. You know, I witnessed something that I disagree with, write about it, put it in some music, put it out there. So I started doing it because it was cathartic for me. And that was my love for music. It wasn't really I wanted to ever be famous or make a lot of money doing it. Mm-hmm. It was because I loved what I was doing. And so that was the start. But then at some point, it becomes a job, and it became hectic, and you have so much obstacles in the way. And when you're not on a major label working with a lot of money and without a lot of support, mm-hmm, you can only do so much. And for me, I think I had ran the ground pretty much of all I could do for myself, by myself. So, and at that point in the mid-90s, I was like, man, after Summer Jam, I'm done. Mm-hmm. Because I'm not going to do gangster rap just because it's the fad. There's a lot, mm-hmm, of people that are not even from that lifestyle, mm-hmm, but will emulate that,
yeah,
because,
yeah,
it's popular to do.
Mm-hmm.
I am not going to do that. And so I just refused, and I said, I'm going to go home and be a at-home dad and raise my kids. And so now 16 years later, somehow reinvented myself with Y'all Busted. Never knew that I'd be 3 years later on a world tour still, but that was what happened pretty much. I got tired of sitting around, and I said, it's time for me to get off the bench and get back in the game.
That's good, ooh, man. I'm right, happy for you.
Yeah,
man.
Thanks,
you're going,
man,
in a good direction, too.
Thanks, man. And it's been a blessing and an honor. You know, we get to, for a good cause, to get to do what you love and get to help other people out and really change the lives of other people in a way. just like you said, just a simple hello
just a little
to
things.
Someone yeah. can make their day. And you know, if my music or what I say or my experiences that I share with people can influence their life in a positive way, that's why I exist. And I'm gonna be here for the long run, man, from the cradle to the grave, not stopping anymore. So they'll get tired of seeing me. I'm trying to catch up with Mick Jagger, who I think just celebrated a
70th
birthday.
Yes.
And man, that's a role model to me. When it comes to running around and jumping around on stage for 2 hours and sweating and all squirrely and kicking and running around with all this energy, and to be in this game for so long, if Mick can do it, I think that's my – he raised the bar for me, so I'm going to be doing it. So 72 years old, we'll be sitting in here.
Right,
and I'll be talking about all the songs that we've been doing over the last 40 years.
That's right. Every year you will be here. In studio.
Well,
that's
thank you.
Sure.
Thank you.
Speaking of a spot.
Speaking of artists that are old, like Mick Jagger, what's one artist that you would like to take off the shelf that's been just gone for a minute and have them open up for you at a show?
Ooh.
Take off the shelf that's been gone for a minute and have them open for me in the show.
Yeah, just like somebody, you're like, man, what happened to this dude? And all of a sudden he's like, you call him up, say, hey, dust it off. Come back and open up for me.
Man, that's a hell of a question right there. I said I had an answer for every question in my day.
You got stumped. You got,
no, I'm not stumped. I'm not stumped.
He stalled me for a minute.
You just want to make sure you get the correct answer.
He hit me with the pause for a minute. But look, I'm going to have to say, not that I would, let me see, on the shelf.
Can I help you out?
Yeah, help me. Help me.
Africa Bambaataa.
That's African Bambaataa is good. No, that one doesn't come to me.
Planet Patrol.
All the whole thing then.
It's not Nucleus. We got the other Chili B's on there. My friend was like, "Yeah, we got Chili B on the show." He goes, "Chili B from Nucleus?" I go, "No, Chili B." He goes,
exactly.
"Oh, okay.
There's a big difference."
And that damn on it.
And because of that is why it's Chili B and no longer Chili B. Because that's a good question. Excited. Okay, back to the answer to your question. Here's what I would do. I would say this. Not that I would like to pull, because they're not on the shelf actually right now. Not that I would want them to open for me even, but I want to open for them. Okay. I want to open for them.
Okay.
You know who I'm going to say?
It starts with a C.
No.
You said them. Is it a...
For him. That's okay. Him. Two people in the
two
group.
Two people, okay.
Two people. Two people.
Yeah, I want to open for him.
For him.
For him.
Give me a hint.
L.A.
Ooh.
Uncle Jam's Army.
Oh, really? You might as well just say Egyptian Lover.
That's what I'm talking about. I want to open for Egyptian Lover.
Oh,
what
gosh.
What is he talking about?
Egyptian Lover, baby.
Egyptian Lover.
That's where it started. I opened for Egyptian Lover my first show, man. Way back in the day was my first show opening for him. So, yeah, I would love to open for Egyptian Lover. Wow. Yeah, right here in Pittsburgh at the Creative Arts Building.
Oh, okay.
Egyptian Lover.
Wow. Here's some little Nucleus for you. Jam on Revenge there.
Yep. So I got a closer show with an old school.
Oh, we got to. I'll find that Egyptian Lover.
You gotta find that one.
So yeah, I just thought of that crazy question, you know.
That's a good question, man. You made me think. Because that's just so many different people.
Because you never know. Now it might be your next thing on your tour.
Yeah. You know.
You're gonna call them up and say, hey, let's do something.
Let's do something, man.
Nice, nice. Well, Chili, thank you very much for being able to come on the show. Talk about everything. Get us all caught up with all the chilliness that's been happening.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for having me on here, man. It's awesome to be here with you guys. And next time, we can't let it be so long, man. I forgot where you lived. It took me so long to get here.
Hey, you're the one that's on tour, not me.
Yeah, so let's do this again.
I always hit you up. Hey, can you do it on this? I can't give you an answer, Slam.
Yeah.
Because I'm on tour. I'm over in Germany.
I'm in Romania. I'm in Hungary. I'm like, damn!
I'm in Slava.
Yeah. I'm in Antarctica. What?
He never go to the Philippines.
Still had his GPS in Hungary, so.
Yeah,
He's taking all the...
Yeah.
But yeah, it's definitely a pleasure to be here, man. This is where... This is musically... This is where it started for me. You know, like you said, in Antioch, Pittsburgh. When I first came here, I moved to Antioch, and... Mm-hmm. And people in Antioch were talking, oh, I'm about to go to Pittsburgh. And I met so many people my first 2 or 3 days here that were on their way to Pittsburgh. And I was like, damn, there's a lot of you guys moving out to Pittsburgh. What's, you know, why are you guys going way out to Pittsburgh? And it's like, no, Pittsburgh is only 5 minutes away. I didn't even know it was a Pittsburgh, California.
Exactly.
So,
yeah, we still get that.
Yeah, but this is for me, this is where the music actually began. And so, yeah, it's kind of like home for me. So I always represent the Bay.
Yes,
when
yes.
I'm on the road.
There you go.
And, of course, I represent, I got to represent North Carolina Rap Squad as well because that's where I'm born. I got to always call North Carolina home.
There you go. Tar Heels.
There, you know it. Nothing could be finer than to be from Carolina.
Exactly, exactly. So what's the Facebook, Twitter, all that good stuff people could follow Chill EB at?
Yeah, just you can send me a tweet at Twitter, /chill_EB.
Make it complicated. There you go.
Yeah, chill underscore, because someone else had took the chill EB already.
Oh,
so I tried to send her a message to tell her she's perpetrating with that name. She had to kind of give it up.
Yeah.
Didn't work too well. But so _chill_EB on Twitter.
Okay.
Reverb Nation /chill EB.
Whoa. There you go.
Yeah.
Just checking the strings. Or www.chillyb.com and take you to my Facebook.
Okay.
And that's always a good way to stay.
Just a forwarding address.
Yeah, to just forward it right to my Facebook. And perfect. And, you know, people could be in touch there.
Cool.
And I'll be updating, you know, as we go with the merchandise and the new music. Like I said, we have three new songs and that are actually going to be on the album.
All right.
And
when is that due to drop?
Well, the target date that we're shooting for the album is actually October.
Okay.
To ship by October.
Oh, so it's just around the corner.
Yeah.
You'll get that thing mastered.
Oh, yeah. And so, I mean, that's kind of what we're going for. We're hoping to be able to knock out at least a couple more videos for these singles that we have. So.
Perfect.
We're just working hard, man, and keep it working.
All right. Cool. All right. Let's have a big round of applause for Chilly B.
Yeah.
And due to time constraints, we're going to go right into our shout outs, and we'll just go ahead and kick it off with Karma.
Since we're so late. Thank you, everybody. Go ahead, Lady Sash.
Oh, okay, that was it.
Is that
I'm going to make, yeah, that's
thank
what he
you, buddy. Everybody.
I'm going to make this short and sweet. Again, thank you for our special guest, Chad. Chilly B. There's a lot of positive vibes going on in this room. I love it. Our guest co-host, Lil Jay's Aaron, and my crew, Slam Karma Stallion, and Miss Dylan, who's sitting here patiently in front of me. And, of course, to all of our sponsors, just go to tvepn.com for a complete list.
Cool.
Yeah, okay, our crew, the Slam Show crew, Chad, Chilly B, good seeing you guys. And we got to do a Slam Show song, you know?
Let's do it.
Next week, get it ready. special
before
guest host.
Before you leave anywhere.
Yeah, we got to get it laced and locked.
Yeah.
Sam will do the beat. So our special guest host, Aaron from Little Jay's Burger, thanks for the hookup. Our sponsors, we got Kenders, we got our sauce ready, Davino's, Bug Assault. You guys got to show you guys about the Bug Assault guns are dope. So when you're out there in the other countries, you see some bugs, you can shoot them.
I don't think you can bring at the airport.
maybe. DJ Henry Customs, Little J's again out there. Drinkware Clothing, BPM Supreme, Natural Life Foods, What's Up, Alex, Perfect Tan, Niner Empire, and online listen is my parents.
Cool.
Oh, let's not forget our newest sponsor, Spectrum Auto Works and Fruition.
All right. Aaron, take it away.
Shout out to Pittsburgh, of course, and to my Little Jay's crew, my family and friends out there, and to you guys all here.
What's all our names?
Everybody right here.
Thank you, Aaron.
I said, I'm like, yeah.
Chad, take it away.
Just want to shout out to everybody. I appreciate the opportunity to come up here. And I hadn't seen this gentleman in such a long time. And it was good to see him again. And good to hear that he's doing a lot in, you know, in his struggle and his fight. And he's continuously doing it without worrying about what people are saying. So I can definitely respect that. And thanks for you guys for the love, the hospitality. I'm going to be speaking with you on
absolutely
some fundraising type things, and I appreciate everybody in this room. And real quick, shout out to a couple of people in my camp. Miss Mimi, chefmimi.com.
Chefmimi.com,
Rising Star PR, K Ross Music, Christopher Ross, awesome guy, Young Deuce, and Prince Sear.
Nice. Mr. B.
I want to shout out to the world. To everybody. Seriously, I want to shout out to everybody, but I definitely want to shout out to Slam and Sam Show for having me back on. I want to give a shout out to LA. We'll see you guys next Saturday in LA. And to my friends and fam in Australia, we'll see you next month. And I just want to shout out to all my friends, my kids, and my grandkids.
Yes.
I love you guys. And remember,
grandkids.
Racism sucks. There's only one race. Peace to the human race.
Well said. Well said. All right. I'll go ahead and close it out. I'd like to thank my entire crew, Lady Sage, Karma, Stallion, our guest co-host, Aaron from Lil J's Burgers. Thank you very much for being able to cater and come hang out with us once again. Our special guest, Chad Briscoe. Thank you, man, for being able to hang out. And I wish you the very best on all your endeavors.
Thank you.
Rap legend, Chili B.
Thank you, sir.
Making his return.
Thank you.
And we will have you all the way up to 76.
Yes, sir.
Every year.
Every year. Let's do it.
And I won't grind the whole grandpa thing because it's just a beauty to continue to have your generations filter on with your DNA and keep that going.
Hey, man, I'm quite honored. Be honest with you, to be here, I'm quite honored because, you know, I've seen so many young people that have not even made it to see 25 or 26. So
very true.
For me, it's a blessing, and I figure I got to represent. You know, I got to represent those cats, and we got to keep it going strong. So I'm here for you guys.
And you're doing a very good job of it.
Thank you, man.
Cool, cool.
I forgot one more real quick. I got to give a shout out to my granddaughter. My granddaughter. My first granddaughter, Miss Mia Marie. And proud of her. And like you said, just happy to be here, you know.
Well said. Mm-hmm. Well said. All right. I'd like to thank everyone that's in the chat room, typing in, and those just watching from afar. Thank you for all your support. Be sure to like our Facebook page at TVEPN The Slam Show, which automatically enters you into our weekly drawing, which we're going to do right now. And this week's winner will get a signed autograph copy of Chili B's track. He brought some classic CDs over, and this is
from the vault.
From the vault.
Yeah.
So whoever wins this week is getting a real prize memorabilia.
It's very valuable. I see those things selling on eBay for $99. I said, just call me up. I'll sell you a whole bunch of them.
There you go. So I'll give you the bowl. And
some kids are like, what's a CD?
Go ahead and read off this week's winner.
Okay, this week's winner, the notorious Baraliv.
Really?
B-A-R-A-L-I. Looks like a V.
Looks like a
R-U.
Right. Or U. Baraloo.
Congratulations.
So, notorious, congratulations.
You are this week's winner, and you get an autographed copy of Mr. B's Super CD.
Yes, thank you. Congratulations.
All right, for myself and everyone here, thanks a lot for tuning in. We'll see you next week.
Peace.
Peace.